Previously on Up at Noon.
Teaming up with DC Comics and Warner Brothers Entertainment for a charity campaign called We Can Be Heroes.
Well, I'm going home to the place where I belong.
Really? That is one of my songs.
Where your loving's always been enough for me.
Anyway, so back to the campaign.
Well, these places and these faces are getting old.
Do I sing like that?
So I'm going home.
That was very Creed of you. Anyway, so
to the place where I belong.
All right, I'm good.
Love
I'm out.
Has always been enough for me.
What's up, everybody? Abrupt stop to the music. I'm Greg Miller. Welcome to Up at Noon. Everyone, please give it up one more time for Chris Daughtry. Great sport. Please support his charity, wecanbeheroes.org. Want me to never sing again on this show? Like the video and leave a comment below. Also, please subscribe to Start. Our bosses promised us if we get enough subscribers, they'd let us use the bathrooms, and I'm sick of holding it in. Great show this week. Destin legarie writes a diary entry about the Need for Speed movie. Mike Drucker has a real request of you, the audience, and I sit down with Casey Wayland of We're Alive. But before all that, here's the news you care about. Sounds good. A maze based on Silent Hill is coming to Universal Studios theme parks. It's the perfect place to bring your kids to feel guilty about murdering your wife. A new study shows that watching TV makes kids less likely to be athletic. For more, we go to childhood obesity expert, Mike Drucker.
This is really true, you guys. Also burritos.
Burritos are our kryptonite. Nintendo is playing down the importance of 3D in its systems. This, after seeing Sony's financials. I'm saying it was a mistake. 3D TVs, we didn't want them. Stop trying to give them to us. Scientists discovered a fifth moon orbiting Pluto. This explains why Pluto's werewolves are so crazy. Wow, okay. If you think you can do a better Pluto joke about the fifth moon, leave it as a video response in this episode. We will feature the best Pluto joke next week. Please don't make it 8 minutes of rambling nonsense.
This is him, Greg. Isn't he beautiful?
High Moon Studios has announced they're making a Deadpool game, which features the superhero's popular breaking of the fourth wall. And looking back at High Moon Studios' previous games, it's easy to see why they're such a great fit for the character.
I'm Optimus, primed for action. Blam, 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 blam. I'm saying what's happening on the screen. Meta humor.
Paul McCartney is working with Halo creator Bungie on music for a new game series. Said McCartney, I'm excited to work with Bungie on this Atari thing that will pay my bills. Engineers at UCLA have developed the world's fastest camera, so finally I can tape myself having sex. It's an embarrassment. Can't even make it through a commercial break. This week, Minecraft players discovered an exploit that would let them sign on as other users. Here to tell us more about it is Brian Altano.
I'm on vacation, bitch.
He's actually on vacation. I'm sorry. That's all we could do. It's all you had time for. Rumor has it that the Kinect on the next generation Xbox will be able to detect depth, which will be super awkward when it realizes Kinect games have no depth. Virgin Galactic has announced that next year they will begin selling voyages to space for $200,000. The company requires passengers to do two things. Take a week-long course before the trip and bring an obituary that newspapers can print when they die in space. People used to train their entire lives for space. You can't do it. Dig.com, once valued at over $100 million, sold last week for $500,000. For more on the story of Dig's rise and fall, check out our thread over on Reddit. Sega has announced a book detailing the history of Sonic the Hedgehog. It's called It's Easy to Run Fast When It's All Downhill. Two new screenshots of Grand Theft Auto 5 were released last week, and you can see them right here. We were also able to get the early prototype of the Grand Theft Auto 5 boxes. They both reveal nothing. And finally this week, DreamWorks has announced that the Need for Speed movie will be out February 7th, 2014. Here with another entry in his diary is Destin legarie.
Dear diary, I guess they're making a Need for Speed movie. Finally, a movie where people race cars. Wait, Fast Five did that. And Bullet. And Cannonball Run. And the one with Nicolas Cage who, can I say I hate? Because he is the worst. It's like he's now playing himself in movies, which is just so terrible. Fast Five was great though. Why didn't they just make that? Remember the scene where they tore out the bank vault or when Vin Diesel and The Rock fought? Those were sweet.
Destin, oddly, we can hear you, but I mean, that scene was sweet.
I hate Greg so much. Brian Altano would be such a better host. YouTube commenter Kansas Jayhawks for Life was right. Greg Miller does have penguin AIDS. But seriously, why do they need a Need for Speed movie? Does EA not have better properties they could be making movies out of? How about a Crisis or Dead Space movie? Or how about a freaking live-action Mass Effect movie? Jordana Brewster from Fast Five could play Ashley. She's pretty and I like girls. Loneliness. Why'd I write that? Anyway, no, we get a Need for Speed movie. Thanks a lot, EA. P.S. Should I tell Greg that I spit in his water and that he shouldn't drink it? Nah. P.P.S. See if Fast Five is on Netflix. I really like Fast Five.
Destin legarie, everybody. It's gross that he spits in my water. Speaking of gross, Gregway, my guest this week makes gross podcast plays about zombies. Here to tell us all about it is KC Wayland. As I live and breathe, KC Wayland.
Hey, Greg.
Hey, KC, how are you?
All right. Good.
Now you're the first person who's ever come here and you're an audio drama.
Yep.
No visual component.
No visual component.
You don't
component.
Understand YouTube. Not helping me out at all here.
Well, we do have YouTube, but then again, it's just like we put up like a picture and then all the audio is underneath. So that's about all we got.
Okay. So for people who have no idea who you are, you run this show called We're Alive.
Yes.
It's about zombies.
Mm-hmm.
It's been going for a couple weeks now?
3 years.
3 years.
2009 we started.
What's the basic crux here for people who need to know?
It is zombie apocalypse, living in LA, and these group of survivors struggling to survive inside of basically a mainstay of a tower.
Okay.
And it's got a large military component, a huge cast, and because it's audio, we can do anything and everything we want to do.
Now, see, that's what's interesting. Like I was talking about, YouTube, it's this big thing. Everybody gets out there, they make these videos. Mm-hmm. You're going backwards. You're going to make radio shows. Radio's not doing so well, Casey.
Well, podcasts are actually doing much better than radio. Radio, the airwaves, people don't want to listen to something live. They want to listen to it when they have the time to. Mm. They don't want to rewind. And so podcast on-demand functions work great. People can listen to it working out, traveling. I mean, that is actually a market that is growing more and more. So yeah, radio's dying, but the digital radio version is growing.
Now, see, so when you attach podcast to it, does that come with a negative connotation? The first time I ever heard about it, someone posted on my IGN wall, there's a zombie podcast you got to listen to. And I was expecting, of course, just a bunch of idiot kids talking about zombies. And then it turned out that it was like this War of the Worlds kind of thing. Do you get that a lot?
We do. A lot of people, when we look at our comment wall, it's like, people are like, I expected crap. But I was pleasantly surprised. So it's like, all right, thanks. You know, that's so we're always raising the bar from crap. It works out well. And it's just, so people do get surprised that, you know, because they're expecting the podcast being low quality. And we basically took the model of, let's make this sound like a film. You're listening to the highest quality we can do inside of a studio, full sound design, and really immerse the listener inside of a world. And to do that without visuals is difficult. But it's also more rewarding because you're painting a picture in someone's mind. They're actually like engaged more so than in a book or any movie you've seen.
Okay. Sounds interesting. We've talked a lot about it. Let's listen to a clip right now so everybody at home can figure out what the hell we're talking about.
Move! Saul, you're driving. Clip the lock.
Start it!
I can't. I have to warm up the glow plug. Forgot about that.
What is that?
Come on, come on.
Oh, oh.
Feel the hat.
You can.
Got it. Hold on. You're everywhere. Run him over. There's one on the roof.
Got him.
it is. Did you really have to run over the commander?
He was in the way.
You swerved to hit him!
Saul, stop f***ing around and get us out the gate.
There you go. See, that's what I'm talking about, right? So, how do you go about recording it and making it sound so good?
Well, we do record in a studio, which is something that we're very fortunate to do because of my position at a university. We get to use their equipment and have actors come in from LA, and we get to have that real engagement of characters live.
Oh, so you bring everybody together at the same
time? Yes. Otherwise, okay. I mean, a lot of animations, a lot of these other third-party productions, what they'll do is they'll have people record in booths, and it's very, like, rigid because they're not interacting with each other. We get stuff like improvisation between the actors. A lot of fun happens on stage where it's just very, very fluid between them. And they, you know, have a good time, and you get a dynamic that you would never get, you know, people talking to a mic.
Before we let you go, why are people so fascinated with zombies, you think? Why is this something that is so big right now? I mean, granted, yours are a little bit different, but same idea. What draws people into this?
I think it's a lot to do with the apocalyptic scenarios that people are drawing from right now. When I look at it and people are in real, like right now in the world, things are not the greatest.
Really?
They're financially, they're fiscally, you know, there's problems people are having, struggling in the world. And I think an idea of a society where none of the debt and all that goes away and you're able to actually, what you put into the world, you're able to get out of it in equal. Like, I think people like that. People want to have that old, you know, colonial idea where it's like you are by yourself surviving on your own merits. And I think people love the idea of what if that happened and I just, you know, my trivial job wasn't trivial anymore. I'm able to fend for myself. And almost, I think it's more fun than real life for people than, you know, what's going on right now.
Wow. Okay, that's deep. That went a lot. if we're at the point in our culture where it's more fun to be in the zombie universe than, man, I got to go to Costco. Jeez Louise, are we in trouble? Before we go then, a lot of information. Zombiepodcast.com for We're Alive. You can get it on iTunes. Comes out just about every Monday.
Yep.
Totally free.
Totally free. Right. You can listen to, there's currently about 30 hours of content right now. You can just, and people plow through the series, but if you get to the end, don't get mad at me that you hit the wall, because we do produce them once a week. It takes about roughly 30 hours an episode, so don't do the math, it sucks. So, I mean, people, they always get the end, they're like, oh, I want, it's the TV series, you know, they're not gonna be producing it any faster, just every Monday, just comes as clockwork.
And then this Friday in LA.
This Friday in LA, come see us live. We got a lot of cool merchandise, a couple of great announcements to make, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
All right. Casey Whalen, thank you so much.
Thank you, Greg.
ZombiePodcast.com. Casey creates fascinating worlds with just the sound and the power of imagination. He's a dreamer, and he's not the only one. One of our writers would like the chance to exercise his imagination more often. So here with an honest, really, really real request of the Up at Noon viewers is Mike Drucker.
Hi guys, I'm Mike Drucker. You probably know me from Up at Noon segments such as Fatty Gets Mad and Fatty Gets Confused. But that's not important right now because I've got a real request. I want to play Dungeons & Dragons with you. If you're in the San Francisco, Oakland area and you have an open spot in your game, follow me at Mike Drucker on Twitter and let me know. You think I'm not serious? Oh, I'm f***ing serious. Let me tell you a story. One time I did a stand-up show with one of my best friends in comedy. Both did great. After the show, a girl said, "You're so funny" to him, and he had sex with her that very night. Same show I did great on, a 14-year-old boy came up to me and said, "Do you want to join my Dungeons & Dragons game?" Here's the second sad part of that story. I played. Third sad part of that story, I quit playing because they weren't serious about it. Because this is real. We don't even have to play Dungeons & Dragons. We can play Werewolf, Vampire, Call of Cthulhu, Pathfinder, and don't get in my face about this being the beginner's box of Pathfinder. I have the full book on my iPad, which I also own, can bring along. These don't even belong to IGN. I want you to know that. These books aren't IGN's books. These are my own books. I paid money for these. I had to bring these onto a bus because I don't own a car. I literally don't have a car, but I have thousands of dollars of role-playing books. Do you know what that's like when you're a 28-year-old man? You don't, because you're probably not out of your teens if you're watching this stupid-ass show.
Let's be honest with ourselves. We're man children. Look at this collection. You can play in this collection. Don't laugh. Don't you dare laugh at me. I have a master's degree. You think I'm playing with you? I was the game master in a Dragon Ball Z role-playing game in high school. We couldn't have dice because dice was gambling, so we programmed our graphing calculators for random number generation. You think I'm playing with you? I ain't playing with you! I stayed at my dungeon master's house when I got divorced. Yeah, I'm divorced. I'm 28 years old and divorced. That's right. I have a lot of role-playing books, though. She took the plates, but I took the role-playing books. Her loss, my game. More time for gaming, less time for crying. Same time for crying, lots of time for crying. You think I'm joking? We've got GURPS, I've got Burning Wheel, Savage World, Death Watch, this weird game where you play angels. I don't know what it is, but I bought it. I literally, it's called like In Nomina. I don't know what it is. I don't. It says Steve Jackson games on it, so it's probably pretty good. I have no, it, look at how beautiful the photos are. They're gorgeous photos. I could play this with you. Both of us!
Please, please join his game. He is so alone. Speaking of alone, outro, it's time we left you alone and to go back to your day. Thanks to Destin Legarie, Mike Drucker, Casey Wayland, not Brian Altano, thank God, and the audience. If you want to be in my audience, go.ign.com/upatnoon for details. Also, as always, I'll be spending the first hour of this video's up responding to comments live on YouTube. Tell me what you thought of the show, I can pretend I can take it, then I'll cry in a dark shower. We'll be back next week, but until then, I'm going back to bed. Woo!